Hi, welcome to Nursing Mantra. I hope all you subscribe my channel. If you didn't subscribe until now, please subscribe the channel to get the updated videos. Today, our class is related to the recent DHA, MOH, Haad and other PROMETRIC questions. We will move through the questions. So this is asked for DHA questions November 2018. And the first question is, if the patient had duodenal metastatic cancer to the duodenum and pancreas, it is metastasis has happened and not affected to other body parts. So among the following, which level you will be assessed? So the levels of pancreas, amylase and the increased blood sugar level, everything was there. So the increased blood sugar level we can select because this cancer, it is reached up to the pancreas. So the production of the insulin, it is affecting because of that, due to that the blood glucose level will be increased. And over infusion of IV fluid, which will overload IV fluid to a patient with a pneumonia, so you will assess for what sound? So usually for the overload, we will be assessing the crackles and the patient will be developing the respiratory distress. To know more about crackle sound and respiratory related sounds, please watch my video related to the respiratory system. I discuss detailed regarding each heart lung sounds. So I hope you all watched my video related to the respiratory system. And there are so many questions related to that number questions, and I was adding every time I am adding all the questions, okay, not only the number. So every time I am getting the questions which is asked, I am adding in below the sections. So many pictures also there, they are asking during the exams. You can see here the x-ray diaphragm for the pneumonia they have asked. And then related to the Croup syndrome and digoxin, okay, the digoxin, the question is they can ask anything related to the digoxin. Sometimes the therapeutic range they can ask, it is 0.5 to 2 nanogram per ml, and the digoxin toxicity, related to the digoxin toxicity they can ask. The signs of digoxin toxicity, that is the hollow ring, greenish yellow circular around the right, okay, and the heart rate is decreasing. Sometimes they can ask like antidote for digoxin, that is digibind, okay. So how we will be administering the digoxin, that means you should check the apical pulse, okay, and like that, and you have to if it is below 60 beats per minute in adult or 90 to 110 beats per minute in children, you have to withhold the digoxin, okay, and you have to monitor the potassium level during the digoxin toxicity, and you have to give potassium rich food you have to give to the patients, okay. Like this, related to the digoxin itself, they can ask like 5 or 6 times different questions in different exams. So that important topic, that one, and related to the Croup syndrome, the causative organism, all those things, okay. Then sometimes in MOH recently they have asked regarding the pulse scale, pulse volume scale. They will be giving the scale based on that one, the characteristics of the pulse they will give, you have to write which score we can give, like that. Easy question already, if they mentioned the scale, it will be easy for us. And related to and that growth and development also, it is important regarding each age group, like toddler, there will be cooperative play, okay. Then pulse pressure is the difference between systolic and diastolic BP, so many things, some of the positions in different diagnosis, what are the positions here they have asked for tetralogy of Fallot, which position we can give, that is knee chest position or squatting position to prevent the right to left shunt. Then like so many questions, it's there in this book. And the developmental milestones, that is more important, and we are getting more confused regarding each textbook, it will be showing different age for all of these milestones. So you can see here like 2 to 3 month social smile, okay, like 24 month can pour water to a cup. They can ask anywhere from these questions for the DHA, Haad, even for MOH also they can ask this question, that also important. And in here I am giving all the questions which they have asked for the exam. And so like urinary tract infection, which type we will give, like example was there for the cranberry juice, so we can give the cranberry juice. And sometimes they can ask related to the nervous system more questions, neurology system, so their sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system, what are the effects, characteristics of that, everything they can ask regarding the cranial nerves, each cranial nerve, what is the function of the cranial nerves. And like that, the main important main topics I have given in this book. And the, regarding the measles, sometimes they can give the picture and you have to identify what is this disease condition, like that in DHA and all they can ask. Then what type of isolation, infection control question will be more regarding the hand washing will be more times they can ask the option for hand washing. Then other types like isolation, type of isolation we have to give, whether it is respiratory, contact isolation, droplet isolation, precautions, which precaution we have to take, like that questions they can ask. Then related to so many conditions and it's related questions that's there they have asked. And sometimes the pneumothorax, like a tension pneumothorax, which side will be affecting, okay, that mediastinal shift towards which side, okay, unaffected side, like that picture also they can provide. Sometimes they can ask direct questions also, and pneumothorax also important. And regarding the tension pneumothorax and its features, management, and the types, open, closed, tension pneumothorax, types of the pneumothorax, and like that, so many things are here they have asked. And I have given a maximum like only the short points I have given, so it is easy to study. If I am giving more rationale and all, it with the book will be more content. This book already it is 800 pages. So more than that, first it was like 1500 pages was there, and I added so many rationales for each things. But later on I felt like it is very difficult to read all rationales and things, so I just edited all the things, only given the important points, that means the exact answer I have given. And in the last pages and all, I have given each system by some of the rationales, that you will be getting a clear understanding, okay, how we can, how this answer came or not, like that. So like here it is mentioned, like what is the LASIK side effect, it is hypokalemia, okay. Then cystic fibrosis, the child plays, so which type of play we can provide there, like a blowing of bubbles, it will help to increase the lung expansion for the cystic fibrosis patients. And phantom limb pain, more questions asking regarding the phantom limb pain. And so many sound, the musical sound we sing, extracellular fluid buffer, bicarbonate, okay, like that. And the pulse deficit, they can ask characteristics of pulse is more important, like pulse deficit, difference between apical pulse and peripheral pulse is pulse deficit, and the compression on the CPR, okay. Posterior patient complaining of severe stabbing chest pain, what it will be, it is a pulmonary embolism, okay, like that. And this is here previously asked DHA hard questions, okay. Post mastectomy, the medicine we are giving, tamoxifen, and the apnea, first symptom is cyanosis, and epidural analgesia complication is hypotension. Then like that, okay. Drug contraindicated in glaucoma is atropine. Then what is the OAS, OR, okay, or left eye means OAS. And if infant is dehydrated, what type of assessment we have to do, absence of tears while crying, okay. This picture they are asking for the, especially I have seen in the DHA questions, so they can we have to point out, we have to mark the exact point. Maybe they can ask you the apex area or right ventricular area, okay, so we have to mark the area, Ebb's point, they can ask the Ebb's point and all. Then position for kidney biopsy, okay, that prone position we are giving and taking the kidney biopsy. And heparin therapy, while heparin therapy we have to monitor the APTT level. Then side effect of thiazide diuretic is hypokalemia. And cancer bladder, the painless hematuria will be there. And post-op patient complaints of gastric pain, what we have to do, we have to ambulate the patient. Okay, like that. If you find a choking client, what is your first response? It is, we have to ask the patient, are you choking? Okay, then how we can prevent the dumping syndrome? We have to avoid the water with the meals. Then like that, so many questions here in this book. I have mentioned everything, and like chest tubes, I already chest tube videos, I already kept the previous video related to the respiratory system. I think in the part 3 it is there regarding the ICD care. Okay, that is most important thing is ICD the care and all. So like what is intermittent bubbling, what it will be, okay, continuous bubbling, what it is, and there is a tube leakage is there, means what we have to do. If ICD is detached, what we have to do. Everything I have mentioned in the video, so you can just watch the video. Then what is the neutropenia precaution? We have to restrict the visitors, and nursing care after cold tar preparation, like used in psoriasis, is avoid direct sunlight. It will be like that. Okay, so the variable deceleration in the CTG, and it is due to the cord compression. Okay, sometimes they can give the graph and you have to identify. Then like a test preference begins at 6 months, and before administering digoxin we have to monitor the apical pulse. Already we discussed that question. And microcytic RBC, it is seen in pernicious anemia. Edema of head and arms, it is a PIH. Lipid reducing agent, simvastatin. And positive bronchoscopy, we have to monitor the swallowing reflex and keep NPO. And here you can see the mechanism of a flail chest, and a paradoxical chest movement will be there in this flail chest. Okay, this is important, that the pancreatic duodenal ulcer and the gastric ulcer, pain after meals and relieved by food is duodenal ulcer. In alcoholics, the type of cirrhosis, we are calling it as Lennox cirrhosis of liver. Then the types of cirrhosis I have mentioned here with the, and this is a nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome picture I have given here, so it is easy to identify what is the symptoms there. And here it is Hodgkin's lymphoma. Presence of here we can see Reed-Steinberg cell. Okay, this is Reed-Steinberg cell and normal lymphocyte. Okay, in the lymphoma, Hodgkin's lymphoma, you can see here. This question was asked for MOH one time. And systemic desensitization, psychotherapy, we are what it is, that is behavioral modification we are doing. And in colostomy, what are the foods we have to avoid, means gas producing foods we have to avoid it. And the odor causing foods, these are the foods which will be causing odor, so we have to avoid all these foods for a colostomy patient. And regarding the PIH, decrease sodium and increase potassium levels, DASH diet, regarding that I have mentioned here. So the rectal suppository, what is the centimeter to give, like that. Each important topics, everything is included related to the nursing. Everything is there in this book, and it is checked with this all, most of the books I checked, and I made the notes clearly. You can see this here, you can see nephritic syndrome is there and nephrotic syndrome is there, and sometimes genital herpes, there will be painful vesicles at genitalia, you can see here in this picture. And hip dislocation, what is the signs, ortholanistic sound, clearly I have mentioned the Barlow test and ortholani test, what is the difference here. Then so many things are there here, you can see here what is anorexia nervosa, and the CSF leakage, how you will be identifying the CSF leakage, means blood spot surrounded by pale yellow ring. If you are putting a gauze swab, okay, if the rhinorrhea through the nose, just keep a white gauze swab or anything, white tissue, anything, you can find out this pale yellow ring around the blood spot. So that means it is indicating the CSF leakage. Okay, it's the same like this picture I have shown here. And any narcotics, we are opioid analgesics like pethidine, morphine, and all, while we are administering, what we have to check? We have to check for the respiration, monitor the respiration, because these medications, it will cause respiratory depression. Okay, like there are so many questions here. It is written tetralogy of Fallot, and the picture also I have given. What is the like each things defects? What are the defects we can seen in tetralogy of Fallot? It is there, and the for the meningitis, what room we have to give? Dim light room due to the photophobia sensitivity will be there. And in the cerebral edema, we have to elevate the head end of 20 to 30 degree. And serum amylase and serum lipase, it is increased in the pancreatitis. So you can see here, so related to the pancreatitis, what are the things written here with the help of the picture for easy understanding. I have given here, and different types of positions in each conditions. Like this, almost I cannot take complete books, okay, all the things I cannot tell in this one video, because it is around 800, more than 717 pages are there. So okay, here you can see each system it is there. I given in a mixed type of format, like schizophrenia, it is here regarding the psychiatry, types of schizophrenia, paranoid and catatonic, disorganized, undifferentiated schizophrenia, symptoms, delusions, everything has written here. And the antipsychotic drugs, okay, some of the psychiatric questions also there. And here it is right-sided heart failure and left-sided heart failure. What is the difference? You can see here. And Down syndrome. What are the signs for the Down syndrome? With the help of picture, I have mentioned. Then Raynaud's phenomenon and the ECG. Okay, normal ECG and the variations of the ECG. Then cystic SLE. What is the characteristic features of SLE? Then myasthenia gravis, all those things, if you are going through this book, it will be easy for you to study without reading any other books. You will pass the exam, I am sure that. And so many questions like this, you can see here. It is MOH PROMETRIC recently asked a question 2018. Everything I have added, like Dembing syndrome, okay, and so many antidotes they have asked, then hypertension, and some of the questions it is repeatedly asking, and I just mentioned it is repeat like that only, because already I mentioned the answer in the above question. So same thing it is repeating, okay, no need to write the repeated questions again and again. And I have mentioned the abnormal sound already. I told that already I done the video for this. Okay, V sound, crackle, strong chain, gurgling, okay, all those things. And the postural drainage, the positions, different positions here. Then, okay, like this, it is so many questions are there. Okay, with the help of the picture here, frail chest, pulmonary condition, what will be there in that effect of that. And some of the questions, it is with the options also I have mentioned. After thoracentesis, the client should be placed in which position? So after thoracentesis, client is placed or turned on the unaffected side to prevent leakage of the fluid in the thoracic cavity. Okay, like that questions, and everything I am adding new questions. Okay, so you can see in this book, so it's so much questions and everything, even community research, psychiatric, okay, all the subjects it's mentioned here, even pediatric and the OB-GYN, everything was there. So yeah, I hope you understand. I cannot take a complete what are the things which is written here in this book, because it is more pages are there. Okay, so this growth and development, usually they are asking for the DHF and Haad exams and all. They will be giving this picture, and we have to identify if the mother is taking some of the medication in the third month, and which system will be affecting for the baby. So like that, they can ask the questions, and the ECG also they can ask whether it is atrial fibrillation, ventricular tachycardia, okay, SVT, or those things they can ask in the exams. Okay, I hope you all understood what is the importance of learning all these review questions, because every time the questions will be repeating and you will be having the idea how the questions will be asking. Instead of reading the theory, if you are reading the question, it will be more helpful. To avail this book, you can contact me through my ask2nursingmantra@gmail.com mail ID, and through WhatsApp you can contact me. And every 15 days I am updating the new questions in different authorities, and I hope you understood my videos. Keep on watching, and please subscribe my YouTube channel Nursing Mantra to avail the updated videos related to the coaching. Thank you.